Bay Area's news station, Cron 4 News at 10, starts now.
And next, stunning new research shows just how many former NFL players have a debilitating brain disease. Tonight, we look into the impact on college and high school athletes. A surprising new study which looked at the brains of former NFL players shows a stunning 99% of them had CTE. That's a debilitating brain disease.
Yeah, the study includes more than just professional football players' brains as well. Cron 4's Spencer Blake spoke with a local sports medicine specialist to better understand the gravity of this latest information.
If you or someone you love plays football, then you should hear the latest research about chronic traumatic encephalopathy, or CTE. Researchers looked at the donated brains of 202 former football players. More than half of them played in the NFL, and others only had high school or college football careers. 177 of them had CTE, including all but one of the NFL players in the study.
That's a scary number at the NFL level.
Dr. David Goltz, a sports medicine specialist who treats many athletes who have concussions, says the study is definitely concerning.
I wouldn't say that it's highly reassuring that American football is safe for preventing brain injury.
But he also says there's a lot left unanswered. For example, this study doesn't include football players who didn't have CTE symptoms during life, nor does it include athletes from different sports. But Gold still sees the alarming report as a springboard for further research.
How many concussions are too many? And this study certainly doesn't answer that question, and that's a big one, I think, for parents.
Certified athletic trainer Kit Holston gets asked about CTE from high schoolers' parents a lot. She wonders if players today have a bit more protection from head trauma than those who were included in the study.
The brains that they did study played high school football back in like the 50s, 60s, 70s. They didn't really have helmets like we do now.
Holston says one positive from the report is that the more we know about CTE, the better trainers and doctors can make diagnosis and treatment plans. And if your kid is already playing a sport that's prone to cause head injury,
the one thing that's under your control is reporting symptoms when you have a concussion. So be aware of the symptoms of concussion and don't try and tough it out and hide those symptoms.
In Marin County, Spencer Blake, Cron 4 News.